of you, what we had discussed in the morning session from Dr. Harian sir class. Can somebody just apprise me, or can we just recapitulate what we discussed in the morning session?
So good afternoon, good evening. This is Prem, and I'll just give you a snapshot of what we discussed. So Dr. Hariharan actually gave us an appreciation about the research, what research is, what are the various aspects of research, like, for example, the various steps involved in a research. And okay. Then we also discussed about the types of research, the research methodology. And obviously, we kind of got an understanding of the element of literature survey, which is very important across all the steps of research, followed by an MCQ that we did. That's what we covered in 1 hour, 45 minutes.
Anybody else, which I think Prem sir has left? Anybody else who can support him, or who can substantiate anything else?
Hi, this is Pradeep Diwari. These are the things. Basically, you know, it was about the foundation of research, and you know, what is the importance of research? Why we do research? Types of research? Then what is scientific research? This was the thing. And he also spoke about what is the importance of research in business? Right. So
yes.
These were the main idea around which the whole session was weaved, and then we had a MCQ at the end of the session.
He also said 5 P's of research.
Okay, what are these P's? Can you just remembrance, can you just recapitulate what
these are? Purpose of research, platform and process, method of research, and pathway of research, and fifth one,
pronouns.
Absolutely right.
Pronouns.
There is no doubt about it. So we will first consider the first P, I think, the purpose of doing the research. Why all people have come here into a platform, and all people have to start of thinking a research. So what is the purpose of doing the research? Before going to the purpose of the research, let us first understand every research we go for a selection of a topic. Because most of the people probably have come from a different background, maybe diversified background, like somebody has come from industry, somebody has come from academics, somebody has come from own entrepreneurship type of things, or maybe somebody has starting some type of new things. So in that case, selection of a topic is very much important, which is related to the purpose. So can we start our session? Just to give me 30 seconds. I'm just sharing the slides for all of you. So is it visible to all of you?
No, sir.
Is the slide visible?
No, sir.
No.
Not yet.
Not yet.
It's uploading at the moment. It's uploading at the moment.
We can't see it yet.
There was a problem, I think, connection. Now it is audible.
Yeah, it is audible.
Yeah. So I'm just sharing the slide. Just give me 1 second. Is this visible to all of you?
Now it's visible.
So now selection of a topic plays a vital role in case of a research.
Barik sir.
So if we go to the research, anybody has joined, madam?
No, sir. You saw the slideshow.
Okay. Just I'm saying. Yeah, is it visible now?
Yes, sir.
So in our particular session, we'll discuss what is a research. Probably Hariharan sir has discussed something else. I will just give little bit hints on the research, what we want to do. What is a PhD that we want to do in case of the PhD? How to select a topic in case of the PhD cases? And what are the things you have to do after the 3 months? Because as you know that once you complete this coursework, you have to submit a research proposal to the university, which should be evaluated by the expert member of the committees. After that, that will be, you can go for a regular, you can say registration. Now you are in the provisional registration. Am I right, all of you?
Yes, sir.
Please.
Yes, sir.
Now, if you see the research, a lot of people have told many things. Research is nothing but something we need to find out that one. Various literatures are there. I'm not going to discuss the various types of literature. Only two things I want to give the highlights on this particular definition. One is systematic inquiry. You know that all people are doing everything else. You are not doing that type of thing which is not getting a research. Probably you have not thought of doing it very systematically. You have seen from the industry. You have worked in the industry for 10 years, 15 years, maybe CEO level or very big level. But you have not inquired into systematically. So that is basically one point. The second point is that when you do a research, probably you have not thought of solving the problems. I'm doing a research from the academic purpose. Most of the faculties or maybe the faculty fraternity that have come, they do because they want to get a degree for their particular thing. So in that case, probably the research have basically two things into consideration. One is it is a systematic investigation or inquiry, finding the various type of information, data, whatever you say. The second part is the solving the problems. So all these things I'm not going to discuss. I'm just putting some of the ideas so that how you will get into this particular area. Now, some of these authors, philanthropists and some of the authors says, research is basically is a problem of interest. Why I'm saying these things? Because since you have come from a different background, do not have a knowledge of how to do a research, but you have an interest. You have a tenacity to do the research. So for example, somebody may be from a pharmaceutical industry, so basically is more inclined to the pharmaceutical product. Somebody is coming from a branding or marketing type of company, then his or her knowledge will be much. Is coming from a consultancy firm like Madam Simi, where she has a lot of knowledge about the consultancy for various types of agencies or maybe World Bank project like that. So she is dealing with that particular thing. Somebody is coming from a financial sector like RBI, his or her knowledge is different. So, but you have an interest. The knowledge is one part because it is the other part of the particular research. I'm just putting these ideas and I'll try to collate how will you select a topic at the end of the research. It is basically a seeking. What I'm saying that it is basically finding out the reasons why you are doing the research. Some people say research is a jigsaw. It is integration of all the components. We try to integrate all the components. I was there in the morning session. I came to know the background of some of the people. I think Raja sir, are you there, sir?
Yes, sir, I'm there.
Okay, so sir, just for 1 second, your background, just can you tell me, just background, if I remember?
Sir, basically, I'm a professionally qualified cost accountant and a company secretary.
That's enough. So basically, Raja sir has a lot of knowledge about the finance because he is dealing with the cost accountancy or that type of areas. I think Roman sir is there, Roman Mukherjee sir. Am I audible?
Yes,
sir.
Jaydeep Mukherjee, not
wrong. Sir, Jaydeep Mukherjee, sir. I'm wrong. I'm just pronouncing a wrong word. Jaydeep Mukherjee, please. Sir, are you there, sir?
Yeah, I'm there.
Yeah. So, sir, I think you have a lot of knowledge in branding, marketing, if I remember from the interview.
As a top management of this MNC company, I handle almost all the departments.
Correct, sir. Yeah. So, sir has a lot of knowledge about a different area, maybe different functional things, different problems he has faced, different strategy he has prepared for the company. So, but when you do a research, it needs a very integration of all these elements, which is very difficult really. Because for a human being, if you integrate all these things, so just for example, if you go to our plate and if you say that mujhe khana khana hai and I want to take the rice and I want to take chapati, I want to take chawal, I want to take dal sabji, I want to take khatta sabji like that, then probably it will be difficult for the housewife or anybody else. But in research, we need to integrate all the components and we have to do a research. Coming to the next concept of the research, which we are discussing. Just one second. Yeah, I think there is a problem inside. Just 1 second. Yeah. Then comes, what is a good research? How will you know that this is a good? It is visible now. Is it visible, the slides? I'm just reducing.
It is visible. Yes, sir, it is visible.
Visible, okay.
Yes, sir, yes.
Now, if you see the good research says that something you do not know, or something you know, probably you not accurately or correctly. For example, I want to know the consumer purchase preference about the mobile phones in a rural area. I know, but I do not know accurately what is that the purchase preference, how they purchase the mobile, what are the things they consider while purchasing a mobile, can anybody influence him or her to purchase a mobile, you know, but you do not know things in a very deeper way. So sometimes it happens that I do not know, but sometimes I know, but not in a deeper sense. So in these two cases, we want to do the research. Am I clear to all of you, sir?
Yes, sir.
Yes, please.
So, now, if we know these things, let us go to other things that in research, probably we do a lot of things and a lot of things will come. It will be more problem. It will be more confused. When you read a lot of literature, a lot of things will be more confused. Don't worry. Ask a particular question. What do you want to do? What I am going to do? Do I am going to the purchase preference? Do I am going to the comparative study? Do I am going to the son of this particular product? Do I am going to the financial statement analysis? Am I going to study the emotional intelligence? So it should be very clear. So the questions that you ask as a researcher point of view, the question should be pertinent questions, so that if you go for finding out the answer, then it will be very easier for you. For example, if you go to a doctor, what they do? So for example, if you go to a doctor, they say that I am suffering from fever. So what is fever? If I say fever is what?
Symptom.
Absolutely. Symptom. Fever is a symptom. So based upon this symptom, and every symptom is a problem. In research, every symptom is a problem. Similarly, for a doctor, every symptom is a problem. If fever is there is a problem. If cough is there is a problem. If there is a feebleness or maybe frequent urination, there is a problem is there. So these symptoms, when the doctor studies, then you diagnose. So in the research, when you study, I'll go to my next classes or next slides, I'll tell you how to find out the symptoms and how to find out the problems, how to find out the solution of a particular problems. So with this ground, so I'm going to the next slide. Characteristics of a good research, what do we say? This slide is very, very important from a researcher point of view. Clearly defined focus, very clear what I'm going to do. Let us say, if I want to ask Sir Anjan, sir, what do you want to do?
I want to do research.
What research?
My topic of my research, sir.
And I'm not asking the topic. What do you want to do? But tell me the broad areas.
I have to first analyze the data in order to come to the outcome.
That's fine. But what data you want to analyze? Why you want to analyze? What do you want to analyze?
So we would start with a problem statement maybe. We have to find out a problem, then explore and then get into a systematic process. And then data gathering has to be a later stage. But
let us go to a very practical one. We should go for a theory. Let us go to practical. Can you just give one example what you are seeing problem?
Maybe actions of the competition. A competition has launched a product which we don't have, for example. This can be a problem statement.
From there,
we move forward.
So it can be
also like this, that we want to introduce a new product into the market.
Absolutely right.
Want to now, get a feel of how the customers would feel about it.
Right.
So if we tell that two things, one sir is giving that competition, another is sir is saying that this is, you would launch to want to launch a product. Now if I say competition, what type of competition? Where? When? How much competition is there? Who are the competitor? Which is the market? Who the company is doing? This company is not sitting alone in the competition. Company is also trying to face the competition. Because when a company is facing the competition, he's also trying to escape from the competition. So these are the some of the questions that comes to our mind. If I go to product launch in the market, what type of product? Which market? Who will buy my product? Why they will buy my product? Very simple. There are many companies in this world. Why they will take my product? What is something there in my product? Then what is something there with other companies' product? So all these questions bothers us. I think these people, those are in the top management, they try to find out how to do that thing. So research is basically find out their things. It should be clear focus. What do you want to do? Should I go to the competition? Which level? Which type of competition? Which market? Which product? If when you go to the FMCG, the competition varies from one brand to other brand. If I go to the wheel and if I go to the other brand, then the competition also varies because the competition for wheel and rein may be different. So it varies, different brand, different product, different level, different market. So the competition varies. So the research, it should have a very clear focus.
Right, like in Hindustan Lever, the Lux, Liril and Lifebuoy are three products competing with each other.
Yeah,
Liril has lost, but then Lux and Lifebuoy still there.
Yeah, some of the competition are the healthy competition for the company. If I say some of the competition, the company try to portray the competition because, you know, to not to invasion the other competitor in the market. So like that, I'm just giving over the background. What is our focus should be very clear in this research. And the process,
Professor,
I think.
Professor, I have a question.
Yeah, please, please. Any question is most welcome because we are in an interactive session.
See, since you are saying the research has to have a clearly defined focus.
Yeah.
And, you know, when we talk about that thing, there is a problem in hand that probably we want to find an answer.
Yes.
So that means if our existing, you know, intelligence or whatever the information that we are having is not sufficient to answer my problem, then probably I would go for it for the research part.
No, there are two things, sir. Yes, you are saying whatever saying is correct. One is that your knowledge to solve the problem. Am I right, sir? If I rectify your conversation. But sometimes what happens, you do not know the area where a problem is. Somebody has done a research in the worldwide. You are looking for the India, but I do not know what is happening in Singapore. I do not know what is happening in Australia or maybe USA. Somebody has done maybe some research. He has gone for far ahead of your topic. So the knowledge you have is absolutely right because your own interest, your knowledge you have. On the other hand, also you need to understand the environment and the research where the things are going on. So that's the reason we want.
So contextual, it can be also contextual. The context
absolutely
makes.
I'm not saying yes, absolutely. It can be for rural also. It can be for urban also. The same product can be for the contextual also. Yes, it is right. Coming
the
to
professor
the third point,
this
sir.
To me, and I have got another question. The example of competition and the example of product launch are brilliant examples.
Yeah. Yeah.
But they are pretty much related to a specific organization or a specific part of the industry.
Yes.
Now, what I'm trying to understand is that is something which we, being part of the senior management, top management, we are required to do in order to plan for the organizational strategy. And we have got teams behind us to do that.
Correct. Correct.
Right. What I'm trying to understand is how is that different from the academic research that we are talking about embarking on? Like,
very good question, madam. Yeah. I think I'll be coming to the next point, the academic and the industrial part of the research, how it is some varies. There's a very clear line and thin line of demarcation. I've just kept in mind, madam, that questions. I'll just try that one.
Sure, thank you.
Then thoroughly planned research design, because you need to have a research design. If you don't go for a research design, then your research will not in a proper way. Ethical standards you need to maintain because plagiarism is there. You need to see that somebody has done in the worldwide and my topics should not be in very similar way. Some innovativeness must be there, maybe 1%, maybe 2%. I'm not saying that we can go for 30%, 20%, or maybe something innovativeness must be there. In my research as compared to other part of the research, limitation clearly defined. We must understand the researcher. We have all limitations. It must be clearly defined in my research. These are the area I have performed, and these are the area I have not performed. So probably there is a scope for further research. If I find,
what is a limitation? If you can just give an example, what is a limitation?
Let us say I want to study the purchase preference. The same example I am giving. I want to study the purchase preference of customer for an insurance product. Am I right, madam?
Okay.
So when I don't do the purchase preference of insurance, then I found that the culture of the people I have not studied probably, which also influenced the purchase of an insurance product. Because the insurance product is normally a push product, it's not a pull product. So when you choose the people and take the insurance, it is not a pool product like our FMCG when we desire and go to the particular market or maybe so. In that case, probably some of the concepts related to culture I have not studied, maybe. Some of the things, maybe some actuary part of the insurance I have not studied. So this limitation should be clearly mentioned in my research. Though I have studied the purchase preference, but I have not taken the culture part of that, which also give me a further research or scope for the further research, which somebody can do. Am I clear, madam?
Sir, I have a question.
Okay,
sir.
Please.
Sir, I have a question. Is that like in this case, then if we are missing out on the culture study, basically speaking on the whole sum, shouldn't the limitations be reduced to the bare minimum? Like there's some things which we, the culture is something which is an integral part of our decision making.
Yes.
So that should be a part of the study. Now, if we have missed that, isn't that an error?
No, I'm not saying error, sir. I'm saying that if my purchase preference of insurance has a link to the culture and I have not studied that one during my research, then I need to mention that in my thing. So this is my one of the limitations which I have not covered up.
So that weakens your research premise in some way, sir?
Could you repeat?
I'm saying, does that weaken your research premise in some way?
No, it is not weaken your research, because even when you are doing a research, sir, you are covering many aspects, but some of the aspects probably you do not cover, because maybe some of the time is one of the constraint, maybe some of the target population too.
Your voice is not audible, sir.
We cannot hear you, sir.
We cannot hear you.
Hello.
Your voice is not audible. Sir, you
probably has lost connection.
I think we lost him.
No, but we see the presentation.
Yeah, the audio connection might have dropped.
Barik sir.
The ma'am, the audio is lost.
Sir, yeah. नेट प्रॉब्लम है आपका.
Yes, now it is audible.
Yes, it's audible.
Yes,
now.
Audible.
There was a
discussion,
I think, because of internet issues. Yeah, so coming to this part, we'll just go by one by one, then justified conclusion. Conclusion should be very justified.
Dr. Barik, can I just come back to the limitations clearly defined?
Yeah, please.
Can we say, just for the benefit of my understanding at least, is this is nothing but scoping it right. Scoping
I've told already.
Research study right. Is that the right way of understanding it?
Yeah. Just I have not done this thing, but there is a greater scope for doing in this research in this particular area. You're absolutely right, ma'am.
So, when we talk about limitations clearly defined, can we re-articulate it for the ease of understanding as the scope rightly articulated?
Yes, I'm saying the further scope for doing the research. I'm telling the further scope for doing the research.
All right. Okay. Thank you.
It's slightly different from the scope.
This is not a disclaimer.
Yeah. Okay. So we go to the next slide.
It is sort of a disclaimer, I guess.
This is not a disclaimer then.
So coming to the
journey. Sir, I have one simple query, sir. Can I ask?
Please. Yeah.
Sir, I was seeing in all of the presentations, which starts about the defining the research problem.
Yeah.
Why are we always using the word problem? Do in all the researches we have to start with a problem? Because when we understand the word problem, it gives us a negative impact that there is a problem. So in every research, are we to start with a problem?
Okay, I'll come into the problem definition. I've kept in mind. I just call it the problem definition. Absolutely, very good question. Very good question, Rajaji. Very good question, sir. I'll come to that part. Yeah, yeah.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Yeah, sir.
Now, I do have a question on this same line. Just actually, in the morning session, Riharan sir said that when there is a problem, there is an opportunity. So, can we think on those lines when we are talking of research?
Sir, just tell me one thing. We are doing a research because anybody has not done or something has done which is not correctly reflected. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, correct. So, for example, we are doing research two things. One is somebody has not done that, or somebody has done but something which is not covered in his or her research. They are doing the research. Now, there is a gap. It is called a research gap. There is a gap. So, this gap is basically for academic point of view, it is our research gap. But for industry point of view, this is the problem that I found out. I'm just giving another example. Let us say the company management says, I seen from 2013, say 2017, my sales is decreasing. So this something is showing to the CEO, is able to see. So this is the trend he is saying. So this is the one of the symptom he is saying. But the problem may be something else. He doesn't know what is the underlying problem. So I'll discuss in detail, sir, in the subsequent slide. I'll go out in detail and I'll clarify this thing so that you will find out the difference between something else, the gap that we'll find, and the problem that we'll identify. Coming to the journey of the PhD. In PhD, it is basically three things are interrelated: the university where you have taken admission, the support of the supervisor, and no doubt the research acumen, the dedication of the scholar. Everybody do the research, probably the three things we have find out, that is the professional growth, maybe in academics, maybe in business, own interest. Somebody may not be interested because he has interest to do the research. Maybe somebody is in business and you know, to get something extra, he need to have some degree. So it may happen there. So because of the three reasons, normally people do the research for the, you can say people take admission in case of the PhD. Now, already I think Hariharan sir, they describe the type of research. Should I describe these things one?
If we Yes, sir, just in brief.
I'm just recapitulating what Sarah discussed. I'm just reframing. If you see, there are three basic type of research we see. There are a lot of classification. If you go to various types of books, various types of classification are there. One research is called very exploratory type of research, very new, brand new. Aap showroom se, when you are bringing the car, brand new, nobody has done. I have done that one. Exploratory type of research. Very new to the problem, maybe you can say to the world, maybe economy, any areas. The second type of research is known as a testing out research. Something is there, we need to test that one. The test may be contextual specific, what Zara has told. The test may be demographic specific, what somebody has told. The test may be cultural specific. The test may be product specific. The test may be brand. So testing out. So in this type of research, we normally say it is basically descriptive things. When something is there, but we need to test that thing. So testing out research. The third type of research is basically demanded by the company or the corporates. It's problem solving research. I think sir has asked a very valid question. In my company, there is a problem. And how do you solve that things? If somebody knows that I am a research scholar in Iqfa University Jharkhand, then you will ask that, yes, I have a problem. Why don't you do a research? Problem solving research. Also, in some of the books, you'll find this action research. You'll find that action research. When there's action immediately. In the academics, we may not get action immediately, but in case of corporate, they need action. So broadly, if we see, the research is basically three times. For you, normally do not go for exploratory study. We normally go for the second type and the third type. That is the testing out and the problem solving research. Is it clear to all of you? Now I'm going very concrete of this academics round. So we always go for testing out and problem solving research. It is better to go for a testing out problem solving research. We should not go for exploratory type of research. Now,
so sir, one question.
Yeah, please.
So from the exploratory research, someone has done it before, and we go through it, and from there we find that there are certain areas probably we or he or she has not covered. So that gives me a kind of an idea or a kind of an opportunity that this particular area can be explored and it can be tested out. So then my research would be a testing out research on that particular area.
But sir, in exploratory, can you come to a conclusion?
No, it is not a conclusion, but probably he has given it some ideas.
So absolutely from... right. The exploratory type of research may go for a longer period, like longitudinal and cross-sectional, what sir is told in the morning session. So the exploratory type of research may go for a longer duration, you may not come to a conclusion. But in case of testing out and in case of problem solving, you will come to a conclusion. During the period of 3 years, just consider as a human being with all these limitations and constraints we have. And so it is better to go, I'm not saying that it is wrong to go for exploratory. People that are there which are going for the pure research, maybe academically they are a regular scholar, they are getting scholar from the university like that. So it is better they should go for exploratory. For us, like a working professional, we normally prefer to go for a testing out or maybe descriptive or maybe problem solving research. Sir, am I clear to you?
Yeah, sure.
Thank you. Can I ask one small question?
Yeah, sure. Any question is most welcome.
Sir, so this insurance example that you had given a few minutes back, so the factors when you are exploring for the insurance purchase, so maybe some work has been done with regards to the US or the UK.
Yeah.
But, however, work has not been done in India to a large extent.
Yeah.
So therefore, will that be falling into an exploratory research?
No, not at all. This is coming to testing out. I am testing in India. It is done in USA, Singapore. It is done in UK, and I am doing testing in India.
Correct.
The result will get in Singapore may not be same the result that will get in India.
Dr. Bhagwat, I have a question.
Yeah, please.
Sir, this COVID-19 impact on some industries, will that be exploratory or?
There are two things here. When the people has come from a new things, like Oxford is doing, I heard Russia is doing some type of research or 2 days back that they are coming with there is a plan to come with a new COVID baby vaccines. So these are basically exploratory type of thing. But the COVID-19 that has been explored in the USA may not be applicable completely to the Indians. So Indian people are also doing the research in particular cases. So,
what I wanted to ask is, suppose I want to study the impact of COVID-19 automobile industry.
Impact. You are studying impact. Means what?
Impact.
Something is there, you are studying now. Am I clear, sir?
Okay, understood. Correct.
So impact.
Okay.
I want to study the impact of this school education to my child. Impact of this to this. Something is there I want to study. This clear? Correct, sir.
So that will not come under exploratory?
No. Impact doesn't come under exploratory. Correct, sir? Coming to the next slide is original contribution. In PhD, most of the times it should be your original contribution. It is very difficult to get a originality from a research. I really admit from all of you as a researcher, maybe 1% you can create, maybe something you have to different. Otherwise, your work will not be validated by the university or UGC or any regulatory bodies. So to make the contribution or make the things to be original, what do you want to do? First, you want to make a synthesis. Read the things which are, for example, I want to study on branding. I want to study on emotional intelligence. I want to study on capital budgeting. I want to study. So read these things from the previous things what you have done. Then try to understand the theories behind that. Can some theories support to that of research? Because when something is there, some theory must be there. And the theory has to be applied to the practical situations. And then you do the research. So let us find out some theories, application, if there is there. Cross-disciplinary. Because you see, I think the VC sir has explained in the morning, we are preferring for a cross-disciplinary approach because many of our scholars may not be very strong in one area because they have a very senior level position. So they have come from the different industry and their knowledge is very broad in different area. So cross-functional or cross-disciplinary approach. Then look from a researcher point of view, the area and the discipline you want to choose. I'll explain in detail in my next slide how these things will be percolated to you. Selection of a topic, which is very, very important from a researcher. When you select a topic, please remember your interest and passion, which is there. For example, somebody may be interested in HR, but he or she wants to do a research in marketing like our MBA students. They do that, there is a lot of jobs in the market, so I will take marketing. But I do not know what is there in marketing. I cannot sustain marketing after 6 months. I lose the job after 6 months. So it may be possible. So please choose your own area and the interest where you want to research. This is point number one. I just request to all of you, please be very careful in choosing a topic because this is your own interest and you want to take. Because most of the times we cannot go for more degree or more research after PhD. Bearing few people do go for postdoctoral or maybe continuous researcher. So your interest, your passion makes a significant impact. Now the second thing is that comfortability. Comfortability depends upon your formal education, your past experience, your current experience. Maybe it may happen that, for example, somebody may be in academics now, but he has not touched the industry and he has forgotten the industry culture, he has left. Somebody may be in industry, he doesn't have the academic also in the knowledge. So comfortability we have to see. So it is depends upon your individual comfortability, synergy and the linkage. The topic that you are choosing and your previous or present experience, how is related? For example, I'll give a very beautiful example that somebody maybe has a job in Pune and he wants to study the adoption of two-wheelers or maybe new design, the two-wheelers that he wants to introduce, he wants to study on maybe Hero Motor Corporation. So because of his synergy, he is a particular automobile industry, is working in the automobile industry. And Pune is a place also, there is a lot of hub of the automobile components. So there is a scope and a greater linkage to his knowledge or her knowledge and the area. So you need to find out synergy or the linkage from your previous experience and the present experience. New dimension, new areas you need
excuse
to look.
Excuse me, sir, can I ask you a question?
Then please, when please, we, yeah, please.
When we say synergy...
Madam, just your name. Madam, name, please.
Yeah, I'm Ritu Ghosh.
Yeah, madam, please.
Yeah. So when we say linkage from the previous work, I just want to check that if before the PhD, now we have enrolled, yeah, and if we have done some work,
yeah,
and we have gathered some data and...
Madam, be specific. I just want to go very specific.
Okay, so let's say I will give an example that if I have done in identifying the preferences of a learning style of a student, of a healthcare professional, and of course there are some outcome of that study that what kind of a preferences of learning style they have, and now in a longitudinal that after 3 years or four years or maybe 3 years now when I'm doing a PhD, and if I would like to see that now in after 3-4 years is the youth have the same learning style preferences or has it changed? So in the PhD, whether can that be considered as a longitudinal? Because if I am using my work, which I've done, and I want to put it in a longitudinal research, can this be considered? I mean, I'm just throwing,
Yeah, absolutely, madam. You see, madam, just the questions that you've asked, longitudinal and all these things will come to step two. My question is that step one is that you want to study what aspects do you want to study learning system for the students?
Learning style.
So you want to study the learning style of the students. Now, if I said that if you want to study the learning style of the student, so do you have some experience in a particular area? If you have some experience, probably it will help you. If you do not have also experience, but you have interest also, it may happen that I have interest, but I do not have experience in that particular field. So it may also happen that. So when you choose a topic, probably you need to be very careful and you need to very, you can say, pros and cons that the area that I'm looking for. Am I clear, madam?
Yeah, thank you.
Coming to the last part is the feasibility to complete. This is not specially applied to the working professional people because all people are working in the different companies with a lot of pressure. So can I complete the job in 3 years? So I should choose a topic very easy. I can do that topic. The topic doesn't have a much more of a research. Also, it is a new topic and I have also interest. So I can complete my research within the 2 or maybe 3 years or 3.5 years or maybe 4 years, depositing my topic, my research areas, my thesis, all these things. So these are the some of the parameters. Please keep in mind when you choose a topic. Any question on this slide? I expect questions from all of you. Any question? This is very, very important.
I have a question, sir.
Please
elaborate about feasibility to complete, sir.
Actually, 3 years along with the personal and professional life. But, can you complete maybe 3 years? But normally in our cases, we extend up to 4 years maybe. So can I complete within these 4 years? What happens, sir? Sir, may I know your name, please? Rajesh, sir.
Rajesh Kumar. I have one more additional question along with that.
Yeah, let me complete the first one, then I'll come to the next one. It's okay?
Both are linked, sir. Your answer comes.
Thank you.
That if you are goes for deciding feasibility to complete, it may be possible that we are going to sever side and that weakens or dilute the purpose of our research, maybe?
You see, many things can happen. Even if there is a sudden change, I cannot say. I think, sir, one of our sir is from TCS. I think Prem Prakash, sir. I think he is a better teacher for all of us, because any type of very things is happening in IT industry and we do not know. After 3 months, we see in the mobile any software is coming. So we do not know what will happen. But what happens probably if you do started a research and probably, yes, you are absolutely right, you may dilute it. But the things that has done, this research may give another thing to these people. I'm saying that it may be diluted, the concept, but it will give a foundation to do the research. Am I right, sir?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Correct. Thank you.
So, any questions? Sir, sir, Silva here, question, I have a question.
Please, please.
Sir, I have one question about the new dimension, because when we say it, that it should be linked with our current or previous work and we should be comfortable, it should be of our interest area. But I did not understand what is this new dimension.
Can you, madam, tell me your own interest area? Can you tell me your own interest area?
I want to conduct a research in HR management.
HR management. So can you tell me what is the new dimension in HR management?
Like AI is a new dimension. So there are many things will be coming.
Like artificial intelligence, application of artificial intelligence, HR analytics is an area,
Maybe
employee retention is a particular area, many of the companies. Then now in this COVID-19 also, there is a problem in keeping these people in motivation is also one of the areas, like situations like any type of disaster, any type of situations also. So many new areas you need to look after. Am I clear, madam?
Okay.
Yeah, I just have one question.
Yeah, please.
This is to do with the selection of the topic.
Yeah.
Now, my area is mainly banking and finance, where you have a large number of data, huge body of data available.
Yes, sir.
So, what is the extent of primary data that I need to generate, given that I already have a very huge data set available to explore?
Sir, can I know, sir? Can I know the area where you want to do the research, the particular area?
I want to study the effect of indebtedness of various sectors of industries.
Yeah. So indebtedness under various sectors. Am I right, sir?
Right.
Is that correct?
Yeah.
So I want to know the indebtedness. This word indebtedness makes a lot of significant impact. So in this word, can I find something else in different or new areas? What will happen? What is the direction with respect to the RBI? Data, sir, is there. You have a lot of data and a lot of also information is there. So it will be easier for you. But whether your research will give to, what is your contribution from the research? To whom will you benefit it? Why you will do the research?
You're asking,
after 3 years,
these are issues that I need to consider.
Yeah, after 3 years or 4 years, if I go to the RBI, if I go to X and Y Z, so can they accept my things? Maybe 1% some innovativeness. I'm not saying it will be 20%, 30% or 40%. So something should be there. Am I clear, sir?
Okay. But is it necessary to generate a primary data for that purpose?
I'll tell you. For that, what you need to do now? Clear? Now there is a steps you need to follow. So what you do to begin with a broad areas of interest. But you start a broad areas. So just for example, most of all these people have now asked the question. So broad areas. So my broad areas is HR. My broad areas is in-depthness. My broad areas is branding. Then broad areas you need to find out. Then do some preliminary literature survey. So pre-literature survey, previous researcher. Some of the funding agency, they have the report also. You can find out some various type of working papers also. IIMs and all of the good people, good institutions also, they have working paper also. Various sources are there and you can find out. Then interact with the people familiar with the similar area. This is a very, very vital. Please remember, sir and madam, if we want to interact, probably many things will come to us. And we do not know because we are working in a very limited atmosphere. So you interact with these people, those are having knowledge in the similar area, analyze and evaluate the alternatives. You need to find out where I can fit. Can I fit to myself what I understood or not? So try to find out the evaluation of alternatives. If not, what next? If not, what next? So you need to find out an evaluation of alternatives, then choose a topic. Don't take a hasty decision in choosing a topic. Take some time, take a judicious decision, analyze, take the help of the faculty from ICFI also, friends also, any other people in this particular atmosphere where you feel they can support you. So take the support from all of you and choose the topic. And of course, we are there to support you. Whenever you give a call, we are bound to give you support. So no doubt
about it. I had a question. My name is Dhruv Sen.
Yeah, please.
Yeah, sir, it is to some extent related to the previous slide as well as with this one.
I'm just
trying to understand what mechanism we should, you know, offer in order to ascertain or estimate the kind of time period it will take to, you know, collect the data, to go to people, to interact with the various sectors from where we'll achieve the primary data. And so that on that basis, we can, you know, to some extent, we can estimate it like, okay, this is the kind of span it would take to analyze all this data, and we would be in a position to arrive at there. So that we can choose a particular topic depending on that.
Very good question, sir. I think you have gone to the data part. Okay. Primarily, it will be very difficult, sir, how much time it will take. One of my colleagues was doing a research in assembly, how they are throwing the chairs in assembly. In Odisha, there was a colleague from XIMP, and he was doing a research how the people in assembly, MLA, why they throw the chairs with anger. So you don't know how much time it will take. It may take also, but normally in academic times, we try to finish this research within 3 to 4 years, taking very small topics. Now coming to another question of your, another part of your questions. What mechanism for you? If I say that, well, now it is an open world because nothing is now closed, and you'll get a lot of sources from any of these things. For these things, you can say for the particular area, you can get a lot of knowledge, though you are not getting time to read the books. But online, sir, I think it is available, a lot of resources also available. And who will support you? Because we are there to support you. We'll guide
sir,
you.
I have a question, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, I have a question.
Please, sir.
Sir, as I understand that this selection of topic is a step-by-step filtering process from a very large span of broader areas, and then filtering and then coming to a specific topic.
On which
we will research.
Yeah.
At what stage we will come to know before choosing of the topic that whether my interest area is researchable or not, in fact? At what stage we will understand that this topic is researchable or not? How we will understand?
Through literature review?
Could I make myself clear at what stage or how we will understand that whether the topic which I am selecting is researchable or not?
Yes.
Very good question, Rajat. I was about to ask the same. I think I'll just add on to that, Dr. Bhatt.
Sir, have I been able to make myself clear?
Yeah, Rajat, sir, I'll just clarify your doubts. It depends upon how fast you grasp to the knowledge that is there and how fast you make a synergy with your topic with the help of your supervisor. So, for example, probably initially you think this might be a topic, I'll do the research. But after studying a lot of things, then you find, no, this may not be the topic which I'm thinking. Probably this is the topic I'm thinking. So, like that, when you go for the alternatives and evaluation, and you will come to an area that this is the area we want to do our research. So for that, if you ask me how much time it will take, it depends upon...
No, sir, I'm not telling about time. I just want to know, based on the topic selected, from the topic, how do we conclude that this topic is researchable or not?
Yeah. Once we come there, then you will come to the objective, because that is a gap you find. Just for example, somebody has done a research in this area. You want to do research in this area, you find a gap. By that, you can go for the research. Without finding a gap, You cannot do a research because somebody has done earlier. If something gap you will find, you can give a research. I will give a very practical example. Sir, can you just tell your area, please? Can you just tell your area?
Though I am working in finance, but I have been working in a multidisciplinary area. So my broader area is CSR as of now. CSR.
Fine. So corporate social responsibility.
Yes,
so
sir.
Corporate social responsibility, there is a regulation by the government and that has been implemented.
Yes.
Different NGOs, agencies, funding agencies, they are doing that one. So you need to find out the gap where there is a problem. The problem may be with the NGOs, the problem may be the government, the problem with the regulation, the problem like, so you need to find out a gap.
Suppose I find that there is an existing problem in finding the in assessing the impact of the CSR activities on the society.
You can do
suppose
that.
I see there is an impact assessment gap.
Yeah, you can find, you can do the research.
Nothing wrong.
You don't care for what type of data, you don't care for where you will get data, but your research will be a solid one. Nobody has done. Probably it will make it difficult for you. That's, you can do a research. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you,
Dr. Bhagwat.
Yeah, Bhagwati, please.
I have a question.
Yeah.
Sir, for this preliminary literature survey, do we have some online databases access from the university? And, you know, like Bloomberg or, you know, there are other research databases also, ScienceDirect and all. Do we have access through ICFI or how do you, you know,
we,
suggest?
Some we should of do this online we have. I think our next faculty will tell you the detail. I'll communicate him.
Okay, sir.
The questions that you have raised, sir. The sources from which you can get some data. Am I right? I mean the literature survey. Am I right, sir?
Right, sir.
I'll put the same thing to the next faculty.
Clarification, not a question.
Yeah.
A small clarification. Is there any minimum words requirement while we complete our work or a thesis?
Yeah, some of the university, they are very strict and they are very word confined. For example, some of the university with the, I have done the research, they are very word confined. 1 lakh words, it should be there. So 200 pages.
What about here, ICFI? How
but ICFI, you don't have like that. We don't have any constraint on that. And the report part, subsequent faculties who will do the research report, they will tell the description of this particular thing. How will do, how much word you have to keep that one. Am I right, sir?
Yeah, and second clarification is 3 months is the minimum or somebody can complete in less than 3 years?
UGC says that minimum is 3 years, but most of the scholars, regular scholars also 2.5 they submit the thesis, but by the get they get a degree, it becomes 3 years.
Okay, thank you.
So, this is the regular, regular students actually.
Yeah.
Sir, a small clarification for me also. Like, I just wanted to understand, like,
sir, name please, sir. So that I'll name, sir. Name, sir.
Rishi. Kumar Rishi. Yes.
Sir.
So I just wanted to have it clarified, like, when we are talking about discussing and filtering out to a topic wherein in future we will pursue our PhD program, will that topic necessarily be towards something which will have a decision-making impact, like whatever research I am doing, that would help the future scholars or any organization in making a decision, or it can be towards just a suggestion that, okay, this is my topic and this is the suggestion which I have proposed.
You say, sir, I think the research report will cover the thing that yes, you can give some suggestions. You can also recommend to the government, to the corporate bodies, to the academicians, to the, you can say the civil societies, you can give the recommendations. And also you can give you can say direction for the future research also. So it is not that key only you can go for a problem solving also, but most of the cases, since we are doing a very limited period, we get something else from our research. So it depends, sir, which type of topic you are choosing and how the things are going on. Sir, am I right? I'm clear to you?
Yeah, clear, sir. Understood.
Professor, just for a clarification.
Yeah.
One thing that you mentioned in your selection of topics, there are 5 things which have been listed, right? Yeah. From interest and passion to feasibility to complete.
Yeah. Yes. Yes, sir.
In that thing, the comfortable is one and the new dimension is one. So yeah. While we have been discussing that, how to choose the topic, how to arrive at that topic and, you know, select that one.
Yeah.
You think that these two aspects, one is comfortability of mind and the new dimension that I bring it to my research, are the two main pillars from which we should be banking upon?
It depends. I cannot say. It depends from maybe whatever you think the two components may be important for you may not be true for any other people. It depends. Somebody else maybe think that my own interest, it may take maybe 7 years to complete my PhD, but my own interest is I have to do. It depends.
Thanks.
Sir, coming to the some of the common mistake in topic selection, what we do? These are the mistake probably we do while topic selection. Topic is a new domain, but scholar is not conversant. This may happen. Topic in a new domain, but not related to work experience for which he feels very uncomfortable. Scope very broad or maybe too narrow. Very broad, you cannot do the research. If too narrow also, you cannot get a outcome of the research or maybe some type of new things that you cannot get. Topic should solve a very specific business problem. I think our previous scholar asked whether it is related to problem or not. Any topic should solve a specific business problem. Clarity, no doubt, in the data collection, where you could get the data, from where, how much time it will take to get the data. And of course, the target populations or the target people to whom, and the effort and the time. So these are the some of the things we do the mistake. Probably some of the times we take a very, we can say, quick decisions to choose a topic. But my suggestion is that you consider all these things and take a right approach. Take the help of our faculty. We are there to guide you. We are there to support you, because probably you may face a problem. I'm the next slide. I'm showing some of the topics that people have chosen in the IFBI.
Dr. Bairik, this is Simi. Before you move to the next slide,
please.
Talking about a new domain or not related to work experience, and this slide, it looks like we're talking about research in a single domain. But for someone like me, my research topic will, in all probability, cross two domains.
Okay.
Right? Multi-domain kind of a research topic. So
okay.
I might not have that much of, I'm from cybersecurity. I have a good understanding of the business area. I have a good understanding of the IT area, but
yes,
not
ma'am.
Necessarily the HR or the HR element primarily.
Yeah,
when we
talk
about culture and all of that, it's HR,
yeah.
Right? So is it okay to make that kind of a mix?
Yeah. Nothing wrong with that. You can choose that topic. It's nothing wrong with that. You have interest, you have experience. Yes, you can choose that, madam.
But my question was, I believe, would I get some support from the university in that cross-domain kind of a research topic? The
yes, why not? Sure.
Okay.
In fact, in the morning, Dr. Rao said that most of us, we will be doing research, will not be of one domain. It probably will touch two domains because
it's
all interconnected now.
Yeah. So these are the some of the topics that I have taken, which our.
Sir, can you please put it on a slideshow mode, because this is too small.
Sure. Yeah. Now it is visible, madam. But,
yes.
So
yes,
these
sir.
Are
Thank
the,
you.
Some of the topics that our scholar have chosen. So it is available. If you go to our website, also you can find out that many of these scholars they have awarded also. That you will find out this topic also. Many people have chosen factors influencing, some people have chosen impact studies, some people have chosen the structural part of the organization, strategic development, some people have chosen. So these are the things some people have chosen. So if you go to our website also, you'll find out many topics are available, and our PhD scholar.
Even the presentation are also there.
Synopsis
and everything there.
Yes.
So coming to my next slide, that is on the journey that you have to do next 3 months, which is very, very crucial for you, because you need to submit a research proposal. After you select a very broad areas of topic, you need to submit a research proposal. And with the help of, you can say, take the responsibility, like spending some time with your work environment. You do a lot of literature survey, read the books or magazines or journals. I know that all people are busy with their professional and personal life, but still you need to spend some time. Try to write something else, because research involves very writing capability. Because if you don't write, probably it will not help you in writing a thesis properly. And most of the times what happens, the thesis has been written by somebody else also. So nowadays it is very easy if you go to somebody else and they can write also thesis. It is now available in the market, which is not good at all for a researcher. Please write your own thesis. It is your own work. It is your own work that you have done. Maybe a little bit difficulty you may face, but space some time. Do a mock courses. I think VCSR has already told. It is depends upon whether you can go for Coursera or maybe as you take many online, you can say sites are there. You go from that courses so that it will enhance your knowledge for that. And these are the some of the things you should do at the ground level so that your knowledge can be enhanced and you will find out a concrete topic for that. So these are the things I want to describe in choosing the topic. So any question of this, now I can summarize from the discussions. Any question from this? Can I summarize my lecture from this?
Sir, one small question.
Please.
Sir, regarding the previous slide in which you wrote about the next 2 to 3 months our exercise,
yeah.
There was one compliance about publishing this right or publish an article in the areas of interest in magazines, journals and seminars.
Yeah.
What I want to know that few of my articles have been published in journals of the Chartered Accountant Institute or the Cost Accounting or the CS Institute. But for my PhD work, what sort of journal in which we need to publish the article? Any specific sort of?
In broad, yes, sir, absolutely. Right. In broad, we are going for UGC CARE. As you know that UGC has, most of the people also probably do not know. UGC has come out many journals called UGC CARE. And okay. Our next speaker, Dr. M. Rajkumar also will tell, publishing, and Dr. M. Jha also will tell. So UGC CARE, we follow that one. Then we go for indexing journal like Scopus, Elsevier, any type of things. But normally, UGC CARE, people can go for the initial stage, preliminary stage. You can go for UGC CARE. Okay. May not be possible for you initial level to go for indexing journal, but you can go for UGC CARE. And many, you can say, reputed journals are there. Where you can try for that for publishing, and okay. we'll help you. We'll tell you which sir. Type of journals will help.
Thank you, sir.
I have one question, Dr. Bari here. Now, this is.
Sir, please name, sir.
I'm Arnav Chaudhary.
Arnav, sir.
My question was that this selection of journal is important because it shouldn't happen that, I publish something in some journal and then at later stage, the institute considers it not eligible. So to have a clear idea of what kind of journals are eligible and what kind of journals are not.
It's a very good question and a pertinent question also. UGC is changing the journal name also from the time to time. You're absolutely right, sir. But once your, you can say, paper has been accepted and published, even if it is out of the UGC CARE, it doesn't matter. It is counted as a thing. No doubt the journal is changing because UGC is trying to try to bring the new quality to the journal. And my next speaker, maybe in the publication section, people will speak more. But in general, sir, you can try for UGC CARE journal, and very common journal are there. My many university also, many private bodies also, they are doing for that. And we'll give some of the listed also, so that you can try for that particular publication, sir.
Thank you
very much. So I want to summarize my sessions. We have discussed that PhD is a journey. It is not the one part. It takes into different things. We try to integrate the PhD. We try to choose a very topic based upon our experience, based upon our knowledge, based upon our interest, based upon our comfortability. And we need to do a very extensive groundwork. So based upon that, I want to finish this, my first session of this, choosing the topic. Then I'll go to how to write a research proposal. Any questions till the time?
Sir, I have a question that this research proposal is same as synopsis of what we are expected to do after 3 months.
I'll come now. I am just coming to you. You should go to
okay.
I'm just coming to you now.
Okay.
Sir, I have a question.
Yeah.
I have a question, sir. Sir, does the research have to be conclusive at the end?
In 3 years, just tell me honestly. In 3 years, what we can do?
Yeah.
In 3 years to 4 years. This is out of the class. In 3 to 4 years, if you don't give a conclusion and new dimension, do you feel any university will award a degree?
No, sir, I'm not saying that. What I'm saying is, of course, in a new dimension, yes, definitely, yeah. Yes. But yes. It may or may not be that, like you, limitations. I'm still coming from that. That because of those limitations, according to my research proposal, this is the conclusion. But that may not be the conclusion. Okay, 4 more dimensions are studied and added, and tomorrow it changes.
Yes, yes.
So that possibility I'm seeing.
Yeah. So what happens? We'll discuss this research proposal. I think the questions that I got, 2 questions I have not answered. I think this research proposal we will discuss, that will be clear. That will give a very clear message. Okay. Now, based upon this, once you select a topic, then you start preparing a proposal. Because once you have a lot of knowledge, then you start preparing proposal. If you don't have a knowledge, then you cannot start preparing proposal. I think most of our friends, or maybe most of our research scholar, agree that when they prepare a proposal, they must get a lot of knowledge, they must get a lot of information or data, or this, after that they prepare a proposal. So proposal is basically a blueprint work plan, what you want to do in the PhD. So basically it is prepared to looking into the PhD student, how you want to do a research proposal. It is a plan, nothing else. It is a plan. There is a research board by every university. Some university that is called doctoral scrutiny committee, or maybe DSC. Some university it is called research supervisory board. Some university say it is a doctoral committee, like that. The nomenclature may be different, but there is a board to approve your proposal. After that, it is go to the competent authority for the approval. So your research proposal has to be approved. That means the university felt that the area, the topic that you have chosen is a researchable one, and you can carry out the research. I think, sir, somebody asked, can a topic may be researchable one? I'm now coming to that part.
I have asked.
Dr. Bari, can we go to the previous slide once, please?
Yes, please, madam. Is this slide?
No, the one before.
Yeah, is the slide?
Yes.
That, if you can put that, please, on the first slide.
No, this, madam, this is the slide plan of presentation.
After that. Yeah.
After this is the slide, madam.
Yeah, after that, sir. Yes.
This is the slide?
Yes, yes.
Yes. So this is your plan. What do you want to study? How you want to study with a quality proposal? I'll give some tips. Don't worry, madam. I'll give some example, and I'll show you how the research proposal is developed by some research scholar, which will give you very good ideas of that. Just give me 30 seconds. I'll go to the next slide. Types of research proposal is basically 2 types. If you find, one is called internal proposal, one is called external proposal. External proposal is normally we give for the funding agencies, grant agencies, government agencies, contractors, non-profit organizations. Internal proposals are sometimes we do for our own research one, maybe academy purpose, we develop a research proposal. Yes. Now this is the part of the research proposal. Now this is a very, very, very important slide for all of our research scholar. In the research proposal, the first one is the choice of a topic. I think we have discussed that part, sir. First one, name of the topic. Is it visible to all of you?
Yes,
sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes. So sir. Name of the topic we have discussed now. The choosing the topic we have discussed, because each topic which you have chosen must be a researchable topic, by which, so topic, name of the topic, first one we have covered. Then coming to the relevance of the topic, how the topic should be relevant to my research. I'll just give an example. I'll come to this slide later on. I'll just give the example. Let us say this is a research proposal developed by a research scholar. Devanjan Sahaji jo hai, is a research proposal he has developed. Please read this particular sentence and particular words. Impact of marketing channel and promotion strategies on adoption of synthetic lubricant. So if you understand this, this is a research proposal. This is a topic he has chosen by the two-wheeler market, and he wants to study in maybe Maharashtra, Pune city, he wants to study. So if you study the research topic, it is very clear. The topic is very clear. He wants to study the impact of this on this. It's very clear. There is no ambiguity on this. It's very clear. You want to study the impact. So the topic, the clarity on that topic will give you a very broad areas to to do your objectives. You know, if there is no clarity on the topic, then probably we find some confusion and leads to many type of questions for all of you. So the research proposal, when you make, then what it should be clarity on that topic. Once you choose a topic, then you go to the objectives. So objectives normally is divided into two categories. One is called broad objectives, another is called specific objectives. I'll give you a very example in addition to this. So in this case, my broad objective is to study the impact of marketing channels and promotion strategy on adoption of the synthetic fiber. This is my broad objective. But my specific objective are, I want to study the awareness, because in order to find the impact, probably I need to understand the awareness. I need to find the buying behavior. I need to find the impact on other channel members. I need to find the marketplace where it is there. So like these are my specific objectives. For a PhD topic, then question comes, most of the cases, the researchers, how many objectives should we keep? Most of the times we prefer to have 4 to 5 objectives, not more than that. Because if you keep more objectives, then it will create more problem for you. Because in each objective you have to satisfy. Without having a proper conclusion to particular objective, then it will create a lot of problem. So that's the reason you must keep mainly 4 to 5 objectives, starting from, you can say, the initial broad objective to 4 to 5, the specific objective. Sir, am I clear, sir? Am I clear?
Not really, sir. So if we go back to the previous slide.
Yeah.
Not this one. Yeah, this is the one. So this one is the topic of the research. Impact of marketing channel and promotion strategies. That is the topic of the research, which is fine.
Yeah.
Now on the next slide, we're talking about objectives.
Objectives. Your objective, you should derive an objective. So correct. I have told you the objective should be broad objective and specific objective. Here, the broad objective is to review the marketing channel promotion strategy adopted. These are my broad objective. One specific objective means awareness, buying behavior, role of marketplace, factors influencing the recommendations. So like it may be happen that your specific objectives may be many, but try to confine the specific objective to be 4 or 5 for your better and controlled research. But if you take a lot of objective, it will become very difficult for you to solve each and every objective. Because if you don't solve each and every objective, then there will be a question mark in the research committee. When you have chosen your objective, why you have not solved this objective? So it is better to take 4 to 5 objectives, especially the specific objective. Am I right, madam?
Sir, understood, sir. But I think where my confusion is,
Tell me.
Point number one and the other points in the slide. You are suggesting point number one as the broad objective.
Yeah.
Whereas the remaining is a specific objective.
Yeah.
The language does not, or if I'm not sure if I'm reading it wrong, but the language does not make me differentiate between the broad and the specific.
No. I think I have mentioned the wrong thing. All these are the specific objectives. Please correct me if I've done.
Okay. All right.
Yeah.
Okay.
Please correct me if I have done this broad objective. All this starting from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 is or a specific objective, but my broad objective to study the impact of this. This is my broad objective. Now clear? Understood.
Okay. Now it's clear. Thank
now
you.
Now it's clear. Okay. Now this is a literature survey you have to do. So for each thing, let us say literature review you have to do. You have to study this literature review from where you have taken these things. A research paper, if it is a research paper, you have to write the research paper. The authors you have to write, like Bass, Frank M, you have to write. Year of publishing, which year it is published. Gist of the points you have gained. Probably this literature, after reading the literature review is basically 20 pages, some literature 14 to 15 pages you have to read, and you have to summarize these things. And how it is related to the linkage to your research. So for example, to understand how information about new and innovative product reaches consumers from you can say users. So these are some of the linkage you find out to, which may help you to your research. So first you have to do that. You have to read each literature or maybe the published article. Then you have to find the gist, what you get, and your linkage to the research. So these are the two important things, the gist that you got and the linkage to your research. So I have given a one example to this. There are many examples probably for you. You may go for 20, 30, 50, or maybe 100 articles for you. Sometimes it may happen that my research, after reading 20 articles also, I may come to a conclusion of my research, or I may get some idea from my research. But sometimes it happens that for my topic, I may have to read 100 articles also. It depends. I cannot say at this moment, because it depends upon the previous researcher work, the type of topic we are choosing, and the literature that is available with us. So, but the gist and the linkage, that in all cases you have to find out. Am I right?
I have a question there.
Yeah.
What is the purpose of literature survey? Is it to ascertain the research gap? Or I can cite the literature in my research as, in my
no, it is, as well. The first one is correct. You need to find out the research gap. So can I proceed? So these are the literature review. So
just one on similar lines.
Yeah, please.
So I just ask. The topic has a lot of research. Obviously, I get access to a lot of data, yeah, which is good for the research. On the other end, if unique topic to work on, but I have less data. So,
could you please repeat? I think there are some disconnection.
So on one hand, if the topic I'm working on has a lot of relevant literature, I get a lot of data. On the other hand, if I do a topic becomes unique, which is an innovative part of the research which we just studied. So either the side, what should a lot of data and a lot of literature which I can refer to, or should I choose a topic which has comparatively a lesser literature and therefore a lesser data?
No, it is not like that, sir. When you read a particular topic, or maybe
sir,
some...
Can purpose, you summarize his question, because we were not able to hear, if you don't mind, please?
Yes, sir. What he is saying that, for example, if I'm reading one article, or if I'm reading one published data, it may happen that I may get lot of data, or I may get lot of literature, or I may get lot of information. All these things are helpful to you, maybe to your research, directly or indirectly. For example, if you find that the data he has collected may be some type of unique data, probably you may require same type of data from a research. So it is helpful. You may not copy that data, but the type of data may be helpful for you. So this is one aspect. The second aspect is that the literature that we have studied, or the methodology he has applied, or the statistical tools he has applied, maybe that statistical tool can apply to your research. It may happen that that statistical tool can be applied. Let us, for example, chi square, a simple statistical tool he has applied. So that statistical tool can be applied to a research. So that you need to find out. Yes, Raja sir has done a research in 1966, and he has applied in chi-square, and that chi-square can be applied to my research. So that you can also point it out. Number three, the concept and the theory that he has followed and referred, maybe that concept and theory may be applied to your area. So like that, you need to find out the gist from this particular literature. It may help to you, may not also help to you. Sir, am I right? I have clearly understood, I think. Explain.
Yes, sir. One related one question. With respect to the literature, if some citation comes, right, like for example, from my area of IT and artificial intelligence, some citation was given that KPMG quoted some research which is in public domain and which that literature has quoted. So as per a KPMG, this was the percentage, you know, which has banking has gone up or down due to AI. Now, can I use that in my research, because that is a public domain which was cited in somebody's...
Yes. You can use. You can take this data or the valuable information from that particular published data. Maybe in World Bank, maybe in RBI site, any of this, you can take that. And you can refer that one. Please understand.
So Dr. Bhatt, I think my question, following it from Mr. Dwari's question, is What are those publicly available sources of data which can be potentially used in an academic kind of a research?
Is
something maybe worth a bit of expansion maybe? The reason being, KPMG data, for example, is subject to change with multiple things, right? Or Ponemon or IBM, my own organization publishes huge amounts of data on a monthly basis. So not all of these, I have been told in other discussions, that could be used as a secondary source of data. There are only certain sources which can be used as a secondary source. So if you can help us understand what are acceptable secondary sources, it would really be beneficial.
Madam, I'll just explain you. After data analysis, nothing is yours. Everything you are borrowing. Very clear in research. Okay. Nothing is yours.
Correct.
After data analysis, whatever, when you get a data, maybe primary data, maybe secondary data, that is your property. You can say, dawa dek aap keh sakta hai. But up to date, nothing is yours. You are borrowing. The literature you are borrowing from somebody else. The methodology you are borrowing from somebody else. The statistical tools you are borrowing from somebody else. The idea that you are borrowing from somebody else. But the data that you have collected from the field, it is your property. And you can say, this data says this. So that is your property. So in the research, up to data analysis, nothing is yours. Everything is borrowed from some sources. Am I clear, madam? I think I have explained.
Okay. All right.
Make a lot of sense. Just just a follow up to that. So when we are quoting, like for example, IBM or KPMG or any of the publicly domain available data, do we need to take their permission to quote that? Okay, or it's just a figure which has come in the market. So do we need?
No, you can take that one. You can give the reference. There is a section called reference section. Okay.
Yes.
Yeah. You can take that one, you can give the reference in the reference section. You can put that I have taken the KPMG data which has been published in 2018 maybe, or sometimes the 2019 also, it has come with a new version. So you can give the reference section, nothing wrong in that.
Okay. So something which is available in the public domain, that is accessible to anybody, can be referred to as a secondary data which has been collected prior to my research.
Subject to giving a credit to that source.
Secondary sources. Data is basically the primary and the secondary. Primary is the data, is the first-hand data that we are collecting from the field. Directly from the respondent is the primary data. But the data collected apart from that, all are secondary. Books, journals, public domain, any publication, wherever, these are all secondary sources. Am I right, sir? Am I clear able to?
Yes, sir. So we are not actually concerned about the nature of data. Our question actually is about, you know, using that data. Can we potentially use the data in our research? So this was the question. And what you have explained, if I could understand it correctly.
How can you use the data of somebody else? You can refer the nature of data, but how can, because you are doing...
I mean, as a secondary source. We were asking, can we use those data as a secondary source? Of course, giving credit to them, referring sources.
You can refer that one. You can refer that one. You can write in the reference section, but you cannot actually... For example, somebody stated 15 or 1500. You cannot take that data now. So you have to take your own data, but you can refer the nature of data that he has taken. And you can cite in the reference section, sir. There is nothing wrong.
So basically, our research will be on our own collected data.
Yes, up to the analysis.
Yeah, that's always.
Up to the analysis, nothing is yours. Everything is borrowed from supervisor, from sources. When you get your own data, then you can say it is my property and I can do the research. And this is I have done.
Like,
but before that, all things are borrowed from different sources. So with your permission, I should move to the next slide. Literature review, already I have told you, these are some of the literature review he has done. After you do a literature review, just make a summary of the literature review. So what do you do that? You make a column where you find that how many articles you have published, how many books you have referred, how many books you have referred, how many journals you have referred, how many research report like KPMG or whoever report, like that you make a summary, a consolidated list of the research. Then you find out the gap. So when you find out the gap, then you write like this. For example, Hare Krishna in 2015 has done a research in this particular area. Maybe Savitri in 2016 has done an area in this area, but there is a gap. There is an area where very few research has done or no research has done, and I want to do in that area. So this is my gap. Now everybody clear? Everybody clear how to find it a research gap? I'll repeat again.
Yes, sir.
You don't understood. This is very, very important from academic point of view. For I'll repeat again. Let us say Hare Krishna in 2018 has done a research on product this. Savitri has done a research on this, but still there is an area where she has not done. So I want to, maybe the gaps, maybe 5, 6, 7, but I want to do one research in a particular gap. I may not touch all the gaps. I may do research in one gap. So I want to do research this based upon my comfortability, knowledge, experience. I want to do research this. This is gap. This is very, very important for the research.
Am I clear? Sir,
I have a question.
Yeah. How do I be sure? How can I be sure that the literature review I have done is authoritative or comprehensive?
Yes, that's my question also.
My question.
No. What you are telling, sir? Can you repeat this question again, sir?
What I was asking is, how do I be sure that the literature I have gone through is the comprehensive literature available on the subject? It's possible that there is some literature which is outside what I have surveyed.
Yes, that's something. You should take that literature which is related to your subject. Let us say, what is your subject area, sir? Can you just broad area you can tell me?
So finance and banking.
Yeah, so banking and what, in-depthness, I think?
So
if you go to the in-depthness, probably you will find 100 literatures which may or may not relate to in-depthness. But maybe one or two literature which I found, which is maybe relevant to my literature. Am I clear, sir? And this one or two...
No, sir, there can be more literature based on that same topic, right?
Yes.
How do we find it? Yes. How do we know that?
We might not come across that.
I'm
explaining the points. For example, when you study the literature review, what you do that in e-literature review, you find the you can say the link to your research, and you find a gap in each literature review. Am I right? When you do a literature review, let us say today you have read two articles. For example, very simple. Today you have read two articles. When you read the two articles of 20 pages, then you find that this literature review may be helpful to my research. If it is not helpful, then you can forget that literature review, or you may not include to your research. But let us say this literature review, Hare Krishna literature review, is helpful to my research, and this is the gap Hare Krishna has done. Let us say in emotional intelligence, Hare Krishna has done a research in maybe Nigeria, but has in this particular research, he has not cited the maybe demographic parameters, one of the area. So it may be one of the area you can start it thinking and doing the research. So the area which you find from the literature review, or maybe the after studying all the literature review, this is the gap area, and you can thinking of doing the research in that area. Now the question comes, sir, if you read 100 articles, we may get a 20 gap, we may get 25 gap, we may get 15 gap. Yes, you may get many gaps you can find out, but you have to choose that gap which will be suitable for your research based upon your own knowledge. For example, the Hare Krishna example that I'm giving, the particular emotional intelligence, I'm not very good at emotional intelligence, but I want to study the professional and personal imbalance due to the emotional intelligence. So I may study that one. So like that, you have to derive a research gap. And I think this will be a good understanding.
No, I think the
gap, what Silva and Mr. Arnav is trying to say, and what also I'm trying to say, is that the gap which we have found out, it may be that gap has been filled up somewhere else in any other literature which we have not referred actually.
Correct.
Right.
Correct.
I just add something. Like we have come across 100 literature, and
there could be 500 20. Other literatures we have not referred.
There could be another 100 we have not come across, and the gap we are finding like 15 gaps. Out of those 15 gaps, 10 have already been addressed. So there remain
maybe all the 15 have been addressed.
That could be. Yes, possible.
All the 15 have been addressed. That means you don't have any gap.
How can we be sure that there is a gap? That is the question actually.
Yeah, so Dr. Barik, If I have understood, I'll paraphrase what all our learners are asking. They are saying, what is the confidence level that I have swept through the literature, confidently covering all the papers pertaining to my topic? That's the question.
Mr. Prem Prakash, the word all which you are using, all is a great sea of literature. All. Yes. How can we confirm that we have referred all the literature?
Yeah. Absolutely. No, that's a question.
I'm just going to explain to you. Yes, you are absolutely right that, for example, you have started a research in 2017, but in 2020, new things has come. It may happen that during last years also some new things has come.
Others can go on mute, please.
I think
somebody's TV is on. Corona vahak rogi, mask pehne hue. Someone's TV is on.
Sir, can you just mute that thing so that it will be very clear?
समाज में धर्म के झगड़े चल रहे हैं. हमको क्लासरूम में बैठकर सेटल करना पड़ेगा कि ये बच्चा जब जाए तो उनके
जरूरत है. प्रभात कुमार का दिखा रहा
है. फ्रेश भी करने की कोशिश करें पर के लड़के नौकरी करने देते हैं.
मिस्टर प्रभात कुमार, प्लीज म्यूट योर माइक.
Maybe he is not there actually.
I'll mute it from here.
Yeah. Okay, now it is okay.
Yes, Dr. Barik, now you can answer that question. Very important question.
Yeah. So the first part is that, sir, when you do the literature survey or review of every article, as I told you, make a column. Like this column, you make a column, which I've sold you, and our university will provide a column. And what you do that when you study any article, you just in this column find out the gap if anything is there, and just find out the gap. And for when you read all these articles, maybe 20, 25 articles, which have been there from up to 2020, because you are now registering for 2020. Now, when in 2020 you do a research and you submit the thesis, maybe 2023 or 24, might be many things has covered, many new things might have done, because research doesn't stop there. Maybe many things have been done in the world. So what do we suggest there? Literature review will do not stop. We allow the scholar to add in the literature review. Any new things that has come, that we try to add. But by the time you have done some research, you have developed some concept, so that will give an added advantage to your scope for further research. You can say that will give for the further research. You have already developed that one. Already you have developed a concept based upon the gap, but you cannot change at the last moment. But you can add this literature review to your thesis, and you can say that this is the advanced area or scope for future growth or scope for future study that you can write out. This is one part. Now, coming to the question which I think Raja Sir has asked, when there will be 15 identified gaps already addressed, if the gaps had been addressed, then there is no question of gap. If it is addressed, then there is no question of gap. Gap means that has not been addressed by somebody else, and there is a possibility of doing the research, and I'm thinking to do research in that area. Gap, if it is identified, addressed, then there is no gap.
The point is, you're right, sir, that we understood. The point is, what we are assuming or that we are understanding that this is a gap may not be a gap, right? I mean, somebody might have addressed it, but the kind of literature we have checked and read, we consider it as a gap, but in reality, it may not be a gap, because somebody might have done that study. So, how to, before agreeing on the topic, that we how to ascertain, how to be sure, how to have a confidence level of 99.99% that this particular gap, which we are saying is a gap, is really a gap. I'm sorry to use gap multiple times, but yeah.
Okay, that's fine, sir. Because when we are deriving a gap or a research vacuum, we are referring to somebody else. We are not saying that from our own monotony. We are referring to that Hare Krishna has studied it and there is a gap I found. Somebody has studied this because we are referring that one. So nothing wrong that one, number one. Number two, when you say that, how can you find that this is a gap? Because it is a public domain and it's been already published by the researcher. So it's nothing wrong in that, sir.
Dr. Barik, the point is... Yeah. So the point is that suppose Hare Krishna and Savitri I have cited, but I have missed Rahul and I have missed Raja.
Yeah.
So the question that we have is that suppose if Raja and Rahul have already addressed my research question that I have already missed, that's where the question is what the...
That's the reason. Yes, absolutely right, sir. That's the reason we tell the research scholar and we give sufficient time to do the literature survey. Choose a broad topic and you study the literature survey. And after that, you confirm the gap. That's the day we give a sufficient time. We don't take a hasty decision in taking the objective or maybe maybe starting the research. So maybe for research proposal, preparing the research proposal, maybe you may have studied less number of literature, maybe 20, 30 like that. But when you choose the particular topic and go for extensive study, then you need to study the literature review. It may happen that you may study 100, 120 articles or maybe more than that. We found that some of the scholars have studied more than 150 articles to find out the gap. So that's the reason we suggest to the scholars that please read that one so that you can narrow down your research and it will be fruitful to you, number one. Number two cases, it may happen that by the time you found the gap, it may happen that some of the new research has come, no doubt. But don't worry for them. You have started a research. You can put that new thing for the scope for the research and somebody can...
Okay. This clarifies our doubt, sir.
Yeah, it is clear now.
Perfect, sir. Perfect. Thank you very much.
Sorry,
I missed the last two. It's just buffering sound. Can you just repeat? Sorry.
Yeah. So what we discussed, madam, actually, I think many of our research scholars asked a very pertinent question. I'm very happy that many people are asking the questions because I feel very proud when people ask many questions rather than the slides. Because our research scholars ask very pertinent questions because when we study 100 articles, it may happen that we miss out some of the things by the time we thought that this is our gap. But don't take what my advice is that when you make a research proposal, it may happen that you have studied 20, 30 articles and you come to a research proposal. You are proposing, you are not conclusing, you are not defining. So you're proposing something else. But one that has been finalized by the university or research board committee, whatever we say in different nomenclature, then you study for extensive research. You go for an extensive literature survey where you found that something, some inclination may be derived. The topic may not be completely different, but something, some inclination you can find out, some direction you can add what sir has told, absolutely right. Some new things has come. So that's how we advise the research scholar, do a very extensive study where most of the times our researcher face a very lot of problem because they do not go on for a very strong literature review. If a literature review is strong, then probably it will give a very good sense of you to formulate your further gap, the objective, the methodology, everything else. After that, subsequent stages, you can go for that. So that's the reason we suggest the research scholar take the advice of your supervisor also, take their help because they are also studying because it is an atmosphere when everybody is finding, they may be also citing many things from the internet and you can find out the best things out of this thing. So with this, can I put the next slide?
Yes, sir.
Thank you very much. Then comes to the hypothesis in the research. I will not explain much more about that. My next faculty will explain the hypothesis. Very simple statement, nothing else. It is basically a statement which you want to propose and you want to prove that statement. So this is nothing but this. So it depends in your research. It may be, don't try to keep too much of a hypothesis. My suggestion is that too much of hypothesis will create you a lot of problem in solving the hypothesis. Because sometimes most of the hypotheses are statistically tested. If somebody is not very good in statistics, don't try to keep much more of hypothesis and take the help of a statistician. They will help you. Because otherwise you may not find a very comfortable stage for defend in case of the PhD final or pre-presentation. So these are some of his hypotheses. I'm just skipping the slides. These are some of the hypotheses. Then scope you need to define. What is my scope?
So if you could just put it on slideshow mode. We cannot see your slides.
Sure. I just already have put that one, sir. I have put that one slideshow mode. Is it now visible, sir? Is there any problem?
Oh, it is visible. It's visible.
It's visible.
I've already put in the slideshow mode, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Scope you need to define. What is my scope of this research? Because in 3 years, 4 years, I may not do all areas. My scope is very limited. If I'm doing the research in Pune city, I need to mention. If I do research in two-wheeler, I need to mention. If I'm doing in synthetic fiber, I need to mention. So my scope is very limited. I cannot write everything else in the research. Sometimes what happens, the researcher to satisfy the supervisor and the university's authorities, from my experience, I'm saying, they try to put a lot of things, which you, I think it is not a good practice to keep all these things. Please write down whichever is good for it. Because remember, many people have a trust on the researcher. What researchers say, we believe, we trust on you. Because we do not have gone to the field. I have not studied what we have studied. So we have a trust on the researcher and we try to believe what the researcher has tried to put. So try to put the correct scope where you are there. Maybe the scope may be for you, maybe Pune city, sometimes maybe Aurangabad city, like that. So you can try to put that scope. Then you write a research design. So research design, my next speaker, Dr. Sudipta Mojumdar, I think he will take up this research design where he will describe whether it is a descriptive study, whether it's exploratory study or a testing out study, whatever I've told you, three broad categories. Then there are sectional categories based upon methods, there is a divisible. Based upon a purpose, there is a divisible. So we have different division of that, and my subsequent fellow, they will discuss. Then write out the target population to whom you are taking the respondents. As you know that we are going for a sampling procedure and you try to study because we cannot cover all the people. So we try to which target people you want to study. Maybe in Pune, I want to take 10 dealers. It may happen. There may be 20 dealers in Pune and I cannot cover all the dealers. So what I will divide the Pune into four regions, east, west, north, south. From east, I will take maybe two. From north, I will take maybe three. Like that, I have to make a sampling design and then I have to draw the sample. So that I depend. It depends upon my own topic, my area of research. So that you try to put that one. Sampling design, already I have told how to do my sampling design. Then what number of sample I have to draw? I have to draw 40 sample, maybe 50 sample, maybe 100 sample. Many statistics now available. Now it becomes very easy to design the size of the sample, maybe 100, maybe 40, like that. And it will be very easy for now to calculate the sample size. But standard practice is also there. So we will help you how to design the sample size when you go for the research. Instrument that you want to use, maybe questionnaire.
Somebody so is there a fixed sample size or is there a like desirable sample size, anything like that?
Most of the times, the sample size is calculated statistically, madam. Based upon your population, if you are going for a probability type of sampling, then it is calculated. Most of the times it is calculated, but we cannot say that there is a standard sample like that. But there are some thumb rules are there based upon certain constructs, some variables also we can define some sample size. So there are various parameters are there. I think further classes our respective teachers will tell you how to define a sample size. It is not 100.
Okay. Okay. Thank you.
So there is a certain things that we have to define, which will be very scientifically tested for that. Then pilot study you have to do. Normally when you do a pilot study, the sample size most we try to keep within 100. Most probably we try to keep the pilot study with the 100. Then we want to study the pilot list. Then we want to take this confirmation that whatever we have designed for our research is all are applicable or there is a deviation. Maybe some of the parameters we have taken maybe deviated from the others. Maybe some of the things we have done. So like that we have to make a pilot study for that.
Sir, quick question.
Please.
So the question is, like in the previous slide, we said that this will take a sample for the questionnaire and all. But take for my example, I have to do a research on a banking IT, usage of AI in banking IT. So if I approach 10 or 15 program managers or CTOs or CIOs, 10 or 12, and I give them a questionnaire and get the result on that. So I just reached out to 10 to 15. I did not calculate this 15 CIOs I'll reach through a statistical method, right? I mean, can you just enlighten me on this regard?
Actually, when you go for the sample calculation based upon our population and all these things, there are certain calculations, like one formula I have shown in my slide also, how to calculate the sample size. So based upon that, you can go for a sample, how many samples you have to survey. Normally, we calculate by some statistical methods or some thumb rules are there, as I've told you. So normally, we follow that one, but don't go for an arbitrary like 10, 15 like that. Don't go for that. It will create a problem.
So,
why are you taking 10 to 15? So we must have an answer. And I think our subsequent teacher will say you
how,
how to go for a calculations. Am I right, sir?
Understood. Thank you so much.
Then what you do that, you have to do a lot of research related activities like exhaustive literature. Already we have a lot of discussion on that also, how to do the literature and all these things, methodology that to be applied, a development of the questionnaires that has to be applied, identification of this concern or maybe pilot study that you have to do so that we can find out that these are the problem with our research. Maybe some of the variables we have taken, may the variables, there is a deviations that we can also find out. So these are the some of the areas we need to do for our research activities. Just one second. Yes, this is a plan of research related activities they have to put in their research proposal. How you do the research plan? When do you want to complete? How much time you have to take for the literature survey? How much time for the questionnaire design you have to take? Pilot survey or pilot study, how much time you have to take? So like that, you have to put a time frame or the plan for the research proposal also. It is required. Feedback from the supervisor, how do you expect? Submission of the draft thesis. So these are things, a detailed plan or your reference or you could say framework that you have to make and you have to put in the research proposal. So this is about the detailed part of the research proposal I have explained, so that it will not you can say create any problem from all of you, so that you can start writing a research proposal. Now any question from research proposal you can ask me, so that I can explain you. Any questions?
Yeah, my question remains the same. So is the synopsis different from the research proposal?
A research proposal is not same that of the synopsis. Research proposal is the proposal that you are giving to the research board for the final approval. But when you are submitting the thesis, or when you are going for the you can say final defense, that you are giving the synopsis. Synopsis is the your entire summary of the research, but this is a proposal that you are giving. Am I clear?
Yeah, okay. So which means that what we need to work for is the research proposal.
Absolutely. Yeah. Then after that, we will go for the complete research. Then we go for the thesis submission, where you go for the synopsis. Synopsis is something
else. Synopsis.
Yeah.
Yes, sir. So what I'm trying to say is that means synopsis is otherwise based upon the proposal what we put.
Of course, sir, when we make a proposal, something is maybe there in synopsis. I'm not saying that everything will be different. Some things may be there, but it may happen that it may also give a new direction after 3 years. I do not know what will happen to my research. Probably I have given a proposal, but the way I have thought and my the data I'm getting, the way I'm getting the responses, and the way the data that I have got and the analysis part also, I do not know. After analysis, that will be very much clear. So this is the format of preparing the research proposal. We have our standard format from the university. I think Madam Dr. Rumna Bhattacharya will send you the format. And this is the real format that I have kept for all of you, so that people can understand and can design a research proposal. So any question from this, can I get?
I do have a question.
Yeah,
please. Hello. So my question is that, sir, we are submitting to the research board the topic of our research through the proposal, project proposal.
Yeah.
It might be that the board might give a green signal so that we can go ahead with the project, or the board might say that no, it is not up to the mark, you have to go back.
Yes, absolutely right. Nothing.
So how we can my question is how we can know that whether we should be going for this project or not on a beforehand, so that the time we are utilizing it is properly there.
Yeah, initially, sir, as I've told you that initially you may not have a lot of knowledge about the data and the final part.
Yeah.
But the concept you can develop, what I'm saying, that this is one time I want to do. Probably the data, you may not be very strong in data. Probably the theories, you may not be very strong in theories. But the concept and this proposed and the idea, that is very, very clear. I completely agree with you. Initially, it may not be very comfortable for you to get some type of data and some type of statistics also. Many people are not well acquainted with the statistics. They do not know which statistics will be applied to my research also. But the concept and this topic that has to be, that you have chosen should be very clear. After that, we will help you. We are there to support you, how to carry a research, how to do a literature review, how to things, we are there to support you. Sorry,
Mike. No, so actually my question is that when the project proposal is going to the research board, I think it is going to the UGC board or
something? No. We are the university board. In the university research board, there is a research advisory board. Then you give a presentation. I think VC sir has told in the morning also. You need to give a presentation based upon the proposal. And if there is a correction, suggestions, and any type of things from the expertise, we'll give their things and we'll try to modify it, we'll try to remold this thing. So then it will be, you can say, beautiful things and you can make these things.
Okay.
Not going to... Any questions, sir, on the research proposal?
Sir, yes, sir. One question.
Please.
Dr. Bhagwat. Yeah, this, sir, presentation will be physically in Ranchi or this will be online?
Now, because of the COVID, all these things are digital. So we do not know after 3 months or 4 months what will happen. But if it is open, then it is good. Otherwise, online, that will things will continue.
So, sir, this proposal in another 3-4 months, we have to freeze.
Yeah, you have to prepare a project proposal. I mean, sorry, the research proposal. Then we will subsequently give you idea because you need to have a research, extensive research after that. So that's the reason I try to put a lot of time on preparing the research proposal, choosing the topic, so that you will get a very good knowledge about that. Apart from this, I will share my number and I'm there in the WhatsApp group also. You can call me from any of the support also. And so there is no problem. We are there to help you.
So, sir, what will be the time frame for us for this?
I think Madam Rumna will tell you, or maybe 3 months or 4 months. So I think she will explain you.
Okay, sir.
Sir, just a clarification.
Sir, Prabhat Kumar this side.
Yeah. Please.
This one, the third topic is design of question is. So, what kind of design of question is?
Questionnaire is a, you can say, instrument to taking the data. Questionnaire means what? It is a collection of questions that you are trying to ask to the respondents. For example, if you want to do a research, I want to develop a questionnaire. So my questionnaire may be 6 pages or 7 pages, and I want to take this questionnaire, which consists of a number of questions, to the respondents, and the respondents to the fill up the questionnaire. So questionnaire is a tool for data collection, or it is a research instrument. So it is one of the tool. There are many tools are there.
Focus
is one of the tool. Observation is one of the tools. It's one of the tools. So many tools are there, and we have to use this particular tools for our own research.
Collecting the data.
Yeah.
Sir, thank you, sir. Thank you.
So any questions, sir?
Professor Barik, if I've understood you correctly. After the course completion, I mean coursework completion, that means coursework 1 and coursework 2, then the research proposal needs to be submitted or needs to be presented?
I think the detail Madam Rumna will tell you, sir. She will have a detailed framework of it, when you will submit that one and how these things are there. She will share all of us thus here. So she will share you the details of that.
Right.
When that deadline is up.
Is there any word limit on this research proposal?
Not necessarily that, but if we go the format this, it will come around 10-12 pages. So not less than that. But word limit doesn't have any word limit, but normally we have a very good research proposal with a concrete concept and ideas, but we do not have any word limit. We do not have any word limit on that.
Okay,
sir. Any questions, sir? I think I have explained these things very briefly, or maybe I've tried to explain this thing so that it will give you a very brief idea to all of you. Now, one thing we have discussed that it is very important for all of us to, divide a research proposal. A good research proposal is always gives a very good direction for the research. There should not be any problem in finding the solution or maybe objective that we set for the research. And of course, we have the university authority. We'll clear you, we'll guide you that how to go for that. So this is about me, sir. Anything else? One thing I have left, sir, in research proposal, at the end, we try to put a bibliography.
Sir, can you go back to the last slide, please?
This one, madam?
Yeah.
This one? Yeah. What makes a good proposal, actually? So a good idea or a good compelling project that is there, maybe one of the areas that you can choose. Many people or many, you can say, our research scholar from the industry, they can choose. So like that, it depends upon if the research...
Sir, what is this good fit with university authority priorities?
This is something that most of the university, though in our university we have interdisciplinary research, but most of the university, they have very specific, because their supervisors are very specific, very, very specialist. And if they do not get the area and the scholar in that area, they will not take the scholars. So this is very specific, most of the university that they have. But in our ICFAI University, Jharkhand, we do not have. So we have very interdisciplinary research. We try to promote among our scholars so that the scholars do not have who are coming from a different background, may not have a deep knowledge in this particular functional area, but we can go for interdisciplinary careers. But some few universities, they are very particular and they take the students only in that particular area. If the scholar, if the supervisor is very good and if the university demands to do the research. Because any university, when they design a course, but this is apart from my research, they go for three things. One is they have a textbook. Second one is they have a project they're handling. Third one is the research they are doing. So if you say Harvard or any good university in management, MIT, so these are the three things. Based upon that, they design the courses. So the research people, they give a lot of input to the academics also, because it is most of the times related. So most of the universities are very confined. Yes, artificial intelligence, I will take artificial intelligence, two students in this particular area, because these are the areas I want to do the research. So it only depends. But in IUJ, we are going for interdisciplinary and considering the different profile of our research scholar. Am I clear, madam?
One question I had.
Yeah.
You mentioned about a bibliography. Now, the review of literature and bibliography, are they supposed to be separate or they can be overlap?
Yeah, this is separate, sir. This is bibliography, that's I'm telling, sir. Bibliography is basically the reference part that we're keeping at the end. When you make these things and we're keeping this reference part, just we have discussed that. For example, Savitri in 2019, there are some format we'll provide you from the research from our university. There are certain format. Normally in reference style, we have a APA style that we are following, but the bibliography will help you certain format. The bibliography basically are the area that we have collected the data, the reference area that we have tried to collect the data. The bibliography that you want to put that one. I think all other points I have discussed, any points I have missed, just may check.
Yes, thank you.
Research design, data analysis, nature and form, the results, budget. Yeah, a budget, normally what happens, this is not applicable to our case, if company, sometimes what happens, the company wants to spend some money for the research scholar. For example, if somebody has from company and company wants to spend some money, so they can sponsor their candidates for the research, but it is not applicable for our case. But sometimes it happens that the company sponsored a particular candidate. So budget is one of the part I have kept for you for the broad understanding. So that normally works, but in our research proposal, we do not try to put the budget. This is very clear. Schedule, there is the time frame, which I have already shown to you, the schedule or the time frame when you want to complete, like dates or maybe probably the dates is a better one. That is the schedule I have already discussed. Bibliography, the use of the format of the university. Every university has their own format. Of course, you will be getting from our own research cell with our different people, they will provide you. So I think I've covered all this part. Anything else I have left? I think I've covered all this part in research proposal. Any questions, sir? This is the main slides where the component of the research proposal I've explained. Appendix is, I have already there. Appendix basically some of the data, but normally in research proposal, we don't try to put appendix. But when the research proposal is given to the consultancy agency, like World Bank, DFID, or NABARD, then we try to put appendix. But on academic research, we do not write put the appendix. We try to put the bibliography, sir. Is it clear, sir? I think I have covered.
Dr. Barik, these slides are would be available on Swadhyay page?
Yes. In Swadhyay, I've already put the slides in detail.
Okay.
If you face any problem, please do me a call. I think now you can...
Dr. Barik, I would like to say something. As the session ends, I will be sending all the slides to them.
Yeah,
right. Thank you.
Thank you very much. That would be a great help. It's a fantastic session we had. So the slides, getting the PowerPoint would be of great help. Thank you, Dr. Thank you, Rosa.
Just a question, sir.
Yes,
you know, in the feedback form that we are supposed to fill up, you know, there is a topic, the title of, so this will be the preparing research proposal, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes, sir. Preparing research proposal.
Now you can give. So now I'm just going to close my session, but before that I'll give some assignment to all of you through Shraddha. So I load the assignment. After your class, I load the assignment. Please go through the assignment and try to complete the assignment as soon as possible. Maybe from the next date or maybe from the next day, I will put the assignment in this Shraddha. I think Dr. Rajkumar and Dr. Sudeep, though, is there. I think they will take the session on how to operate the Shraddha so that it will be very good for you. Before that, I want to do a quiz for all of you. Is it okay? We'll play
yes,
this game.
Of course.
Now we have studied too much. Let us play this game. So we will use the squeezy model. I'm just giving this particular WhatsApp to number to you so that you can start. We will go for the squeezy for that. Just 1 second, sir. I'll operate from here. So I'm stopping the slide.
It will be MCQ.
Yeah, it's MCQ. Nothing to worry, sir. Not some big question, very easy question for all of
yes,
you.
Yes, yes.
Sir, most of us are back to studies after a long time.
Yeah. So, just 1 second, give me, I just will go through.
Can you give your number also, sir, so that we can send...
My number, yes, I'll give you. It is available in the WhatsApp 94990. It is there. Last is 854.
Huh?
Last is 854.
Please repeat that.
Can you repeat it, sir?
994-55-55-854.
Oh.
This is my WhatsApp number also. I am there in the WhatsApp group. So I think it will not be any problem. But still, if you face any problem, we'll support you through our WhatsApp group. Just 1 second. I'll go through the quiz part. I'm just logging that. Give me some seconds so that I will just operate from this side. Yes. Sir, everybody can go to a site called Quizy, Quizizz.
Sorry?
Hello? Quizy.
Sir, kya?
Just go to an online site, I'm just saying.
Sir, can you
I'm typing here so that it will be easier for you.
Is it quizy.in? .in?
Yeah. Just go to that site.
Can you repeat that thing once more?
The URL is mentioned in the chat box. You can check.
Okay.
come in?
Sir, one second, just.
Something else.
He's asking for a game code.
Yeah, yeah, I'll give the game code, sir, to you. Just one second.
Sir,
code just write down 8701. I'm just typing. Just log in.
8701-7603.
Yes. Everybody
is
logged in.
Sir,
which option?
Join. Just logging in, sir.
Sir, code I have given, sir. That is 8701. Already I have typed. Just log in. So everybody log in. Then we can start the.
We have to give our name and start game.
Yeah, just write the name only because I can come to know. Write the name.
Yes. And we have to start the game.
I will start that one. By that time, just wait. Just write your name. Everybody has logged in or any problem?
Yeah.
I have logged in and written my name.
11 candidates had logged in. Other people have not logged in actually.
Yeah. I am having a problem. It's not opening.
It's
asking for Gmail details and all that.
No.
You have to go to Quizzy, madam. Then after that, you can go for that.
You just check the chat box. The link is mentioned. You just click on that link. It will be asking the game code as well as your name. You can type.
Before that, it will ask you to join a game. Click on that. And after that, you have to enter the code.
Shall we click start game, sir?
Just wait, sir. I think many
people... Okay.
Sir, okay. I haven't logged in yet. Just a second.
Okay, 13 candidates have logged in. Other people, I think, try to log in.
Still facing a problem, actually. The window is not opening. I'm still facing a problem.
Okay. Sir, I'm not opening, actually, this side.
Please give your full name and give the code, then it will automatically come. Now, the rule of the game is that each question you will get 60 seconds. There are 10 questions.
Sir, can you repeat the code once again, sir?
This is 8701-7603.
But I'm not getting any questions, something like that.
No, questions you will get, madam. I have not started the quiz.
Okay, got it, sir.
Because, once all these people just log into that thing, then you can start the
quiz. Yeah.
Me, showing the blank page. I don't know. It's just blank.
So this side also, it's showing a complete blank page.
We'll start the quiz. Just you give the code and just wait.
Okay, now it has opened.
There's no place for give the... code or because it's just a blank.
Sudipta, sir, can you technical help us, sir?
Refresh the page.
Same problem. It opened in the second attempt. Just refresh it. It will come for ask for a code at the left side.
Yeah. So 13 the candidates have joined, sir. Uh, who is having some problem to join?
I am having problem.
Madam, name please.
Ritu Ghosh.
Okay, so what is the problem that you are not able to get this code?
So when I'm clicking on that or copy and pasting into Google, then it is just the page is coming white.
Sudipta sir, are you online, sir?
Ma'am, you just click on the link which has been provided, quizzes.com/join.
I did that, Mr. Sudipta. I did that.
You just refresh and redo that in a new browser if you can. Maybe that can solve the issue.
Let me try that.
So apart from Ritu, madam, anybody has not joined, sir?
No, we have joined.
So everybody has joined except...
Yeah.
Shall we start the game?
Just wait let's see, wait for 1-3 seconds. I think madam Ritu is trying
I'm trying with the refresh.
Sure, please.
This is a very interesting software, and I thanks to Dr. Sudipta Mojumdar and all other faculty members who have given a training to all of us. And this is a very interesting software by which you can find very interesting to give the answers.
I'm sorry. Again, I tried. It's the same thing.
Okay. So Sudipta sir, can we start with this following people?
We can do it for Ritu ma'am. Later on, sir?
Maybe so we can do something else for
Mom. Yeah, true. Everybody else have joined, I guess.
Ritman, you can try it on your mobile also.
Let me try.
Ha, look at the spelling and then type accordingly, ma'am, in your mobile.
Okay.
Madam, are you able to connect?
It's just opening. Yeah, let me just. Yes, I think it's some round is going on.
Yeah. That's very interesting.
Yeah. Enter a game code which you have given. Yes.
8701-7603.
And then I say join again.
Yeah. I'm starting the game. So everybody is ready now.
Yes.
We are ready. Yes, sir.
We will click start the game.
Yeah. Now we'll find the question and give the answer.
We have a sample pilot test sensor.
So should we say start a game? Should we say start a game?
Yes.
I've already shown these things.
So start the game and start attempting.
This question is 30 seconds, I think. So should we go to the next question?
Sir, I'm continuously
going. Yeah, we are also continuing.
The selection is getting the next question.
Yes, sir, we are attempting.
Yeah.
You attempt and you complete. Okay.
Sir, have you finished?
No, sir.
No, sir. No, sir.
Okay, fine, fine.
Barik, sir.
हाँ सर
हाँ सर मेरा स्क्रीन शेयरिंग थोड़ा एनेबल कर दीजिए काइंडली
सर ये
इसका नंबर
नहीं आ रहा सर व्हाट डज द मैनेजर रुमना मैम आप से अगर कर देंगे
यस सर
मेरा स्क्रीन शेयरिंग एनेबल कर दीजिए तो
हाँ ठीक है रुमना मैडम कर देंगे
ठीक है
नाम ही नहीं आ रहा
सर ये स्कोर नहीं आ रहा है सुदीप्त सर
यस सर
स्कोर इसका
हाँ
इसका स्कोर
आ जाएगा सर डैशबोर्ड में आ जाएगा आप एंड गेम मत करिए अभी सर बिकॉज
हम कुछ नहीं कर रहे हैं अभी
यस 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 लेट देम कंप्लीट द क्विज एंड देन यू विल गो फॉर
इट पब्लिकेशन स्कैनिंग मस्ट कर दिया टू पुट अप प्रेफरेंसेस
वेरी डिफिकल्ट सर
द नीड्स ऑफ कॉलेज इंस्ट्रक्टर्स बिकॉज ऑफ द नंबर
प्लीज मेंटेन साइलेंस नो
सर यू कैन म्यूट योर माइक एंड रीड
सर हो गया
यस 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 फाइन फाइन मैम थैंक यू
ओ माय गॉड इट्स रियल टाइम
तो क्वेश्चन भूल हो गया ओके
आई कंप्लीटेड
मायसेल्फ कंप्लीटेड
या आई आल्सो कंप्लीटेड व्हाट्स द पोजीशन इट्स शोइंग 8 द मोर एंड मोर पीपल कंप्लीट इट विल गो डाउन Minus 6. Oh. Oh my god, someone is at top also.
Barik sir, it's a good site. We can play by our own also.
Now you have to give that quiz, sir. This is a quiz we are taking from online because nowadays everything is going through online. So we are taking.
No, like if we also want to do something like this in our office, so is it like friendly? We can use it, no?
Yeah. I think our fellow colleague Dr. Majumdar will help you on that aspect. He has taken training also.
Because it's quite interesting, sir.
Yeah. The people will pay attention to it.
So, you are getting a scoring, madam?
Yeah, yes. I got 8th now. Earlier it was 6th, now 8th.
It's basically like fastest finger first in KBC because quizzes actually applies to algorithm.